So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 18th and 19th of July 2021. Starting with very first question, NTPC Renewable Energy is to set up India's first green hydrogen based mobility project in which Indian state or union territory? So already we have covered this news and we have seen that NTPC REL has signed a pact with the union territory of Ladakh to set up a green hydrogen mobility project in the region. So do remember that Leh would be the first city in the country to implement a green hydrogen based mobility project once it would be completed. And for this purpose, NTPC is set to ply 5 hydrogen buses and also to set up a solar plant and a green hydrogen generation unit there at Leh. Also, NTPC's first solar installations in Leh in form of solar trees and a solar car port were also inaugurated. Now apart from it, do remember that Ladakh is the first Indian Union territory to achieve 100% first dose coverage of COVID-19 vaccine. Also do remember that this project is under the pact which was signed between CESL, that is Convergence Energy Services Limited, and the Ladakh administration, and they have decided to make the Ladakh carbon neutral. And for this purpose, CESL will develop clean solutions for home appliances, electric heating, etc. in the very cold temperatures in Ladakh. Along with it, it will also focus on EV ecosystem utilizing the renewable sources of power. Then apart from it, recently Ladakh has launched UNTAB scheme for students there, and under this scheme 12,300 tablets is to be distributed there, and it is an initiative of Department of School Education. Who is the Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh? It's R.K. Mathur. And one more important thing, our former Lieutenant Governor of Jammu Kashmir, who is G.C. Murmu, has been appointed as External Auditor of OPCW. What is it? Organization of Prohibition of Chemical Weapons. Can you tell me where does the headquarter of OPCW lies? And our present Lieutenant Governor of Jammu Kashmir is Manoj Sinha. So these are some of the important things regarding both the Union Territories. Question number 2. India has opposed the move by developed countries at World Trade Organization to scrap subsidies in which sector? So India has recently opposed this move to scrap subsidies for fishermen. Actually, India demanded a balance between current and future fishing needs of developing countries as well as effective special and differential treatment. So India justifies its opposition that it wants to get the subsidies for low income, or you can say resource poor fishermen, while developed countries see this as a distortion in the global fish markets. So this was the issue there at WTO. Now apart from it, recently Union Ministry for Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying has launched an online course mobile application named as Matsya Setu for our fishermen. And this application has been developed by ICAR CIFA. What is CIFA? It is Central Institute of Freshwater Aquaculture. So this app comprises of species-wise or subject-wise self-learning online courses module. And the aim of this application is to disseminate the latest freshwater aquaculture technologies for aqua farmers across the India. Apart from this thing, MPEDA, that is the Marine Product Export Development Authority, and NCDC, means National Cooperative Development Corporation, they have signed a memorandum of understanding to promote export-oriented marine products. Also, in February month, we have studied that an investment of 400 crore rupees was decided to be invested in which state of India to make it the fisheries hub of the country. So this state is Goa. Then Rashtriya Gokul Mission was in news these days. And do remember that this is a scheme under मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फिशिंग एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड डेयरिंग. कैन यू टेल मी विथ व्हाट थिंग इट इज रिलेटेड टू. क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, बास्टिल डे विच वॉज सेलिब्रेटेड रिसेंटली इज द नेशनल डे ऑफ विच कंट्री. सो दिस डे इज ऑल्सो नोन एज नेशनल डे ऑफ फ्रांस एंड इट इज ग्रैंडली सेलिब्रेटेड देयर ऑन 14th ऑफ जुलाई एवरी ईयर विथ fireworks and lot of parades. Actually, this national day is celebrated in remembrance of the fall of Bastille on 14th of July 1789, and it was on the same day when an angry crowd stormed and captured the military fortresses and prison there at Bastille where political prisoners were held captive. Apart from it, recently USA has also celebrated its Independence Day. Can you tell me which date was that? Then apart from it, recently 7th edition of IONS has been hosted by France. What is this? It is Indian Ocean Naval Symposium. And it was concluded at Reunion Islands, which is a French department in Indian Ocean. Then also, few days back, Indian and French navies have conducted Varuna Naval Exercise in the Arabian Sea. Then there is one more important exercise, the name of which is X Desert Night 21. Actually, it is a bilateral air exercise between Indian Air Force and French Air and Space Forces, and it was to be held in Jodhpur, Rajasthan. Apart from it, ISRO has recently signed an agreement with CNES, which is a French space agency, and it has been decided that CNES would help India in its first human space mission called Gaganyaan. Question number 4, what is the theme of the World Youth Skills Day 2021? So in the year 2014, the United Nations General Assembly declared 15th of July to be celebrated as World Youth Skills Day. Why? To celebrate the importance of providing young people with skills for employment and entrepreneurship. So this year the theme for this day was reimagining youth skills post-pandemic. And as per UNESCO, COVID-19 pandemic resulted in the widespread disruption of the technical and vocational education and training, that is TVET sector. Then let's revise some of the days quickly. 1st July is celebrated as National Doctors Day. Then there is Chartered Accountants Day and National Postal Workers Day. This day is actually celebrated to thank and appreciate all men and women who work consistently and deliver all our mail and packages. Then 2nd July is celebrated as World UFO Day. Then 4th July, I am not telling you because I have already asked this question to you. Then 7th July is World Chocolate Day. 11th July is World Population Day. 12th is for Paperback Day. Then 17th July is celebrated as World Day for International Justice. This one is quite important. And 18th is also important. It is Nelson Mandela Day. Who is Nelson Mandela? He is South African's first black president and social rights activist. Okay. Then apart from it, 12th July is celebrated as World Malala Day, as she fought for the education of children. And in India, Article 21A is for right to education. So under this, it has been decided that state will provide free and compulsory education to all the children who are between 6 to 14 years of age. And this has been added later in the Constitution with 86th Constitutional Amendment Act. Question number 5. Which country's National Plastic Surgery Day is celebrated as World Plastic Surgery Day? Actually, plastic surgery is said to have originated in India itself. And APSI, that is Association of Plastic Surgeons in India, introduced the concept of National Plastic Surgery Day in the year 2011. Since then, on 15th of July, the day has been observed in India when plastic surgeons across the country perform free operations and conduct awareness programs. And once APSI presented about the day's success at the World Council of Leaders, which was organized recently, finally, July 15 has been accepted as World Plastic Surgery Day. So here correct answer is option number 2. Now apart from it, Supreme Court of India has announced on 16th of July to implement system for safe digital transmission of its bail orders to jails across India. Now under safe digital transmission of bail order scheme, authorities will not be required to wait for authentic orders to release the prisoners. Okay. Also recently, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has inaugurated Rudraksh Convention Center in Varanasi. And do remember that India launched Bheem UPI services in the country Bhutan. Also recently, central government has imposed stock limits on wholesaler, retailers, etc. who are related to pulses to control price rise under stock limits and movement restrictions on specified foodstuffs order 2021. Then also recently India has announced intermediary guidelines and digital media ethics code, and as per the rules, all significant social media intermediaries had to publish their monthly reports on the details of their complaints and what actions they have taken further and various other monitoring details of their platform. And recently Facebook has launched its first monthly report. Okay. Question number 6. Which Indian state or union territory approved the inclusion of affordable rental housing complexes, that is ARHC scheme, in its master plan 2021? So recently DDA, that is Delhi Development Authority, approved this scheme in its master plan 2021. So this will facilitate budget rental housing for poor and migrant workers who are living in urban areas there at Delhi. Actually, this scheme was given the cabinet approval in 2020 July with an aim to provide affordable rental housing for migrant workers. So this scheme is related to Delhi. Then there is one more scheme from Delhi called Mukhyamantri COVID-19 Parivar Arthik Sahayata Yojana. Actually, this is a social security scheme to provide financial assistance to families who have lost a member due to COVID-19 pandemic. And under this scheme, 50,000 rupees would be provided to every family who have lost a member, and additional 2,500 rupees per month will be given if the deceased was the sole breadwinner, means the only income earner in the household. Okay. And for this purpose, Chief Minister has also launched a portal to implement the scheme. Then there is one more campaign from Delhi. It's Jahan Vote Wahan Vaccination. And under this, people with age group of 45 years or 45 plus, they can directly get vaccinated to their respective polling stations. Then also DMRC, that is Delhi Metro Rail Corporation, launched India's first FASTag or UPI based parking facility last month. And according to a report which has been shared by Delhi police recently, crime against women there has increased by 63.3% in first 6 months of 2021 against the crime rate in 2020. Now one question for you. Can you tell me which state has launched a scheme called as Agricultural Diversification Scheme? Question number 7. Whitetail Clean Energy Project, which was making news recently, is set to be established in which country? Actually, it is also known as United Kingdom's first net zero emissions power plant, and it is set to be established at Teesside. So the project will use a process which combusts the natural gas with oxygen instead of air. So air will not be used in this process. And also, to drive the turbines, it would not use steam, rather it use carbon dioxide in a fluid state. So the process is set to eliminate all the air emissions, including traditional pollutants and carbon dioxide, which will be captured and stored under the North Sea. Apart from it, Prime Minister Narendra Modi had participated in the outreach sessions of G7 virtual summit, which was held in Cornwall in June month, and it was hosted by United Kingdoms. Also, India and United Kingdom have launched a new work stream to promote industrial energy efficiency. And this was launched under IDDI of CEM. What is IDDI? It is Industrial Deep Decarbonization Initiative. Fine. Question number 8. Which union ministry designed and launched the School Innovation Ambassador Training Program? Actually, our Union Education Minister Dharmendra Pradhan, along with Tribal Affairs Minister Arjun Munda, launched this program. So your correct answer is option number B. And the program is jointly designed by Innovation Cell of Education Ministry and AICTE. Can you tell me what does AICTE stands for? And actually, this program aims to train 50,000 school teachers on various things like innovation, entrepreneurship, then there is design thinking and various others. Now, apart from it, India's first artificial intelligence powered grievance management application has been launched by Ministry of Defense with the help of IIT Kanpur. So this is also the first artificial intelligence based system developed to improve grievance redressal in the government. And also this tool can understand the content of the complaints and it can also identify repeated complaints or spam automatically. Also these days, Prashad scheme is very much in news. It was actually launched by Ministry of Tourism in the year 2014-15. And what does it stand for? It is National Mission on Pilgrimage Rejuvenation and Spiritual Heritage Augmentation Drive. Why it is in news? Because under this scheme, the construction of Tourist Facilitation Center has been inaugurated. Can you tell me who is our tourism minister? Then there is one more scheme, COVID Tika Sangh Surakshit Vandhan or Udyam. This campaign has been launched by Tribal Affairs Ministry. And the aim of this particular campaign is to break various type of myths, rumors and misinformations related to COVID-19 vaccine. Question number 9. As per the GST law, for how many years states were guaranteed to be compensated for loss of revenue in GST implementation? So as per the GST law, states were guaranteed to be compensated bi-monthly for loss of revenue in GST implementation for total of 5 years from 1st of July 2017. So for this purpose, the government has borrowed and released 75,000 crore rupees to all the states and union territories to compensate them for the shortfall in GST revenue. Actually, this is in addition to normal GST compensation being released every 2 months out of actual cess collection, and this release aims to meet the resource gap due to the short release of compensation. Recently, 44th meeting of GST Council was held and it was chaired by obviously our Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. And in this meeting, it was decided that several changes in GST rate that have been made would be applicable till September 30, 2021. For example, GST rate for ambulance can now be decreased from 28% to 12%. Then GST rate for hand sanitizers can also be reduced from 18% to 5%. Then similar for temperature checking equipments, GST rate can again be decreased from 18% to 5%. So there are lot many things like this which would be applicable from September 13. Apart from it, earlier we have also studied that Finance Minister has decided to issue Certificate of Appreciation to more than 54,000 GST payers for their timely filing of returns and cash payments of tax to mark the 4th anniversary of GST Day, which was on 1st of July 2021. Coming to last question, which social media platform discontinued its feature named as Fleets? So recently, Twitter has announced to shut down its Fleets feature from 3rd of August. And the reason for discontinuing is its failure to attract more users. Actually, Twitter introduced the disappearing stories feature in November last year, and it is similar to Instagram. But unlike normal tweets, Fleets disappear after 24 hours and it do not get retweets, likes or public replies. And people can only react to the fleets with direct messages. So that's why it was not gaining much attention, and hence Twitter has decided to discontinue this feature of fleets. Apart from it, we have seen that Twitter has recently appointed Mr. Vinay Prakash as resident grievance officer to comply with new IT rules of India. Also, first MD of NARL, that is National Asset Reconstruction Limited, is Padma Kumar Nair. Can you tell me who is our present Chief Minister of Uttarakhand? Please let me know in the comment section. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. At the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today, and we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Satsana signing off. So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 20th of July 2021. Starting with very first question, which institution has launched a new scheme named as FASTER, the full form of which is Fast and Secure Transmission of Electronic Records? So this has been launched by Chief Justice of India N.V. Raman, and under the scheme, the Supreme Court will instantly transmit bail and other orders to the jail authorities, district courts and the high courts. And this process will be done in a secure way electronically. So as per the present practice, hard copy of the bail order received by hand is mandatory, but now this process would be completely electronic. So here correct answer is option number B. Now apart from it, Supreme Court has recently issued a notice to Centre on use of section 66A of IT Act, which was actually scrapped in 2015. So what does this section says? Actually, it provides punishment of maximum 3 years in jail along with some amount of fine on sending offensive messages through computer or any other communication device such as phones or tablets. So earlier, Supreme Court had struck down this provision in 2015, but still there are about 745 cases which are pending and active before district courts in total of 11 states. So that's why Supreme Court has given notice to Centre to comply it with the rules, and hence in result, central government has directed all the states and union territories to withdraw FIRs under this section. Now I hope this act is clear in your head. Now there is one more section of IPC which is quite important. It's section 377, and it is related to LGBT. And do remember that first country to legalize same-sex marriage is Taiwan. And recently Hungary has passed anti-LGBT law which bans this type of content from schools. Now let me make some space to discuss our fundamental rights. So I am removing this picture. Actually, this is related to your polity section, because lot of people gets confused in section 377. It is related to IPC and not the Indian Constitution. Okay. So in the Indian Constitution, there are 6 fundamental rights which have been provided to each and every citizen. 6 fundamental rights are there. First is right to equality. It's from article number 14 to 18. Then second is right to freedom, article number 19 to 22. Then third one is right against exploitation. It covers trafficking and exploitation of women and children, and it is related to 23 and 24th articles of Indian Constitution. Then fourth is right to freedom of religion, means you can adopt any religion whatever you want to, and it deals with 25 to 28. Then fifth is your cultural and educational rights. It's 29 and 30 articles. And most important article is the last one, right to constitutional remedies. means if you feel that the above five fundamental rights are getting exploited by any person, you can go to high courts or supreme courts. Okay, and one more important thing is this right has been declared as heart and soul of the Indian constitution by which personality? B.R. Ambedkar. So this is a quick revision of your fundamental rights. And this LGBT things come into right to equality because it says that you cannot discriminate any people based on RRCSP, means race, religion, caste, sex, place of birth. Okay, so do not get confused between IPC and the Indian constitution. Okay, question number 2, which country chaired the 7th BRICS labor and employment ministers meeting held in July 2021? So already I have told you many a times that for this year, BRICS presidency has come to India. So whatever events and conferences would be held this year, it would be presided by India. Okay. Along with this meeting, earlier we have seen that there was first ever BRICS employment working group meeting. And again, it was hosted by India. And various issues were discussed in this event, like how to formalize our labor market and how to increase the role of women in the labor sector. Then one more event is there from BRICS. It is BRICS Foreign Ministers Virtual Meeting, which was hosted by India once again. Talking about BRICS, it has 5 countries: Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. South Africa is the latest country to join this organization. Then recently, we have talked about Dushanbe, which is Tajikistan's capital, and it was the venue of recently held SCO meeting 2021. Or you can say Shanghai Cooperation Organization meeting. And in this event, our External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar also participated. Then talking about some more important host, few days back there was 17th BIMSTEC Ministerial Meeting and it was chaired by Sri Lanka. And the BIMSTEC has 7 countries, and which are they? India, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Bhutan and Bangladesh. These countries are from South Asia. Then apart from these 5, 2 more are there, Thailand and Myanmar, from Southeast Asia. Now talking about G20, there was G20 Labour and Employment Ministers meeting and it was hosted in blended mode by Italy. Then also there was Global G20 Health Summit and it was again hosted by Italy along with European Commission. Also do remember that Italy was the host of COP26 along with United Kingdoms, which was held in Glasgow, which is a city in Scotland. So this is a quick revision of your host and event. Okay, who is India's Union Minister for Labour and Employment? It's Bhupendra Yadav and he chaired the 7th BRICS meeting. So in this event, the 5 countries resolved to recover with stronger national economies, inclusive labour markets and social protection system. And do remember that 6th meeting of Labour and Employment Ministers was hosted by Russia in Moscow in the year 2020. Question number 3. India recently held a virtual maritime exercise Shield with which countries? So recently India, Sri Lanka and Maldives National Defence Force held a maritime search and rescue exercise named as Exercise Shield. So this TTX, or you can say the table top exercise, was held virtually and it aims to share best practices and fine-tune procedures to curb narcotics smuggling in the region. And do remember that Indian Navy's Western Naval Command was the lead agency and the exercise was coordinated by Maritime Warfare Center, which is at Mumbai. Apart from it, recently we have seen that India and France has conducted the Varun Naval Exercise in the Arabian Sea. Then there is X-Desert Night 21 Exercise and it is a bilateral air exercise between Indian Air Force and French Space Force. Then there was 7th edition of IONS, which has been hosted by France recently. What is this? Indian Ocean Naval Symposium, and it was concluded at Reunion Islands, which is a French department in Indian Ocean. Now talking about Maldives, it was in news recently because Foreign Minister of Maldives, who is Abdullah Shahid, has been elected as new president of United Nations General Assembly. Also, India and Maldives have signed a memorandum of understanding for cooperation in sports and youth affairs. Then there is one more exercise named as Shantir Ugrasena, or you can say it as front runner of peace. This was held in Bangladesh. Between which countries? India, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Bhutan. So these were the countries which participated in this exercise. And do remember that Bhutan has become the first country to use India's Bheem UPI. And Bangladesh was in news due to its Haribhanga mangoes. Why? Because Bangladesh Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has recently sent these mangoes to Prime Minister Narendra Modi and West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee. So this is also known as mango diplomacy. Then Sri Lanka was in news because the Sri Lanka Central Bank has announced that it has minted two coins. One is gold and the other one is silver to celebrate 100th anniversary of Chinese Communist Party. Talking about military exercises between India and Sri Lanka only, one such exercise is Mitra Shakti. Now you have to tell me the name of one such exercise which is held between India and Maldives only. Question number 4. Geera Sara Bhai, who was in the news recently, was associated with which field? So she is veteran, architect and designer. And why she is in news? Because she has been passed away recently at the age of 97 years due to obviously age related illness. And she has played a vital role in founding NID, that is National Institute of Design, by bringing in topmost people of the world as faculty. And she also established Calico Museum of Textiles, which houses some of the rare specimens of textile from different parts of the country and the world. Now talking about some more important demises. First name is Stan Swamy. He is priest and tribal rights activist, and recently he has been passed away. Then second is President of Haiti, Jovenel Moïse, and he has been assassinated recently. Then there is Sundarlal Bahuguna. He is the founder of Chipko movement. Then also we have lost a veteran athlete, Milkha Singh. And do remember that he is the only athlete to win gold at 400 meters at Asian and Commonwealth Games. Then there is one more name, Kenneth Konda. He has been died recently. And why is important? Because he is the founding president of Zambia. Now apart from these things, let's talk about some of the recent appointments. First is Sher Bahadur Deoba. He is new Prime Minister of Nepal. Then Israel has its new Prime Minister. And who is it? Naftali Bennett. Then Ibrahim Raisi is the new President of Iran. And you have to tell me, Bashar al-Assad has been sworn in as a President of which country? Question number 5. Child Tax Credit Program is a flagship program being implemented in which country? So recently the United States government has started providing monthly payouts as part of an expanded income support program. So now under this program that has been further broadened under recent COVID-19 pandemic, all the eligible families collect an initial monthly payment of up to $300 for each child under 6 years old and up to $250 for each older child. Okay, so this program is from USA. Now apart from it, government of USA has recently unveiled an online hub for the victims of ransomware attacks. So this will actually help the companies and municipalities to find resources and get assistance if they are targeted by cyber hackers. And the government has also announced that it will pay a reward up to $10 million to the person who can provide useful tips to track down cyber criminals who are backed or directed by foreign governments. Then apart from it, US Senate has recently passed a legislation to ban the import of products from China's Xinjiang region. Why? As the US has been condemning China for genocide against Uyghurs and other Muslim groups. So this is actually Uyghur Forced Labor Prevention Act. Now can you tell me from which countries Indian Navy has bought MH-60 Romeo helicopters recently? Question number 6. Jacob Zuma, who was in the news recently, is the former president of which country? So he was the president of South Africa from 2009 to 2018. But after being charged for corruption, he became the first South African president since the end of white minority rule in the year 1994 to receive a prison sentence. So this arrest has triggered looting and violence in the two most popular provinces of the country. First is Gauteng and second is KwaZulu-Natal. And a record wave of COVID-19 infection is also grappling the country. And the current president of South Africa is Cyril Ramaphosa. And to control the silence, over 25,000 troops have been deployed. Now apart from it, Muhammad Yunus is important. Why? Because he will receive the Olympic laurel at the Tokyo Games 2021. And he is the Nobel laureate from Bangladesh. Actually, his pioneering work of micro-lending has led to much poverty reduction across the globe. Hence, he would be honored for his extraordinary work in sports for development. Then talking about Tokyo Olympics, flag bearer for this event is MC Mary Kom and Manpreet Singh. And they will be flag bearers for opening ceremony. For closing ceremony, the flag bearer would be wrestler Bajrang Punia. And the flag bearer for Paralympics would be Mariappan Thangavelu. Question number 7. Which Indian institution has developed a heat-tolerant COVID vaccine? So recently, IISc Bengaluru along with MinVax has developed a heat-tolerant COVID-19 vaccine formulation which has been proven effective against all current SARS-CoV-2 variants of concern according to a study in animals. So this formulation also projected hamsters from the virus and remained stable at 37 degrees Celsius up to a month and at 100 degrees Celsius for up to 90 minutes. Apart from it, do remember that Covishield must be kept between 2 to 8 degrees Celsius while the Pfizer vaccine requires a specialized cold storage at minus 70 degrees Celsius. Now apart from it, IIT Hyderabad has developed Covi Home, which is an artificial intelligence powered COVID-19 test kit for self-testing at home. And as per the team, the kit can provide COVID test result within just 30 minutes at home for both symptomatic and asymptomatic patients. Then IIT Guwahati has developed smart window material which can automatically control climate of buildings. Also, IIT Guwahati has found the ways for better water management policies in India through virtual water analysis. Can you tell me how IISc Bengaluru is related to ARWU rankings? Please write in the comment section. Question number 8. North-South gas project is a gas pipeline agreement between which of the two countries? So recently, Pakistan and Russia have signed an agreement for construction of 1100 kilometer gas pipeline from Port Qasim, which is in Karachi, to Lahore. So this project is commonly named as North-South Gas Project and it is also known as Pak Stream Gas Pipeline Project. So a special purpose vehicle has been formed between Pakistan and Russia with a shareholding of 74:26%. Now apart from it, Pakistan Parliament has recently passed a bill which criminalizes torture and prevents custodial deaths by police or other government officials. And talking about Russia, recently Union Cabinet has approved Memorandum of Understanding between India and Russia on cooperation in coking coal. Can you tell me in terms of coking coal, which state is the largest producer? Question number 9. Which union ministry launched the COVID Tika Sang Surakshit Van Dhan or Udyam program? So this has been released by Ministry of Tribal Affairs and it aims to fast track the pace of COVID vaccination among the tribal people in India. So this campaign will focus on 45,000 VDVK, that is Van Dhan Vikas Kendra of the TRIFED, means Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India, and it will be implemented with the help of traditional village headsmen, self-help groups and ground level workers in the villages. And who is our minister for tribal affairs? It's Arjun Munda. Apart from it, recently Education Ministry has designed and launched School Innovation Ambassador Training Program. Also, recently India's first artificial intelligence powered grievance management application has been launched by Ministry of Defense with the help of IIT Kanpur. So do remember that this one is also the first artificial intelligence based system developed to improve grievance redressal in the government, and hence this tool can understand the content of the complaints and also can identify spams and repeated complaints. Coming to last question, Boh Valley, which was seen in the news recently, is in which state? So this is in Himachal Pradesh, and a heavy monsoon has led to flash floods in Bhaksunag region and lower Dharamshala areas. Also, a massive landslide has been reported in Boh Valley, located about 30 kilometers from Dharamshala. Apart from it, an earthquake of 3.6 magnitude has also occurred near Shimla of the state at a depth of 10 kilometers from the mean sea level. Now talking about Himachal Pradesh, recently cultivation of India's first monk fruit from China has started in Kullu, Himachal Pradesh. Then there is Bol Bum Yatra, which is in news these days. Why? Because it is usually held in the state of Odisha, but this time due to COVID-19 pandemic, the state of Odisha has decided to ban on the religion activities and congregations of Bol Bum devotees. And earlier, Uttarakhand government had cancelled the Kanwar Yatra for second term in a row. And our new chief minister of Uttarakhand is Pushkar Singh Dhami, and you have to tell me with which constituency he belonged to. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comments. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today. And we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Sarsana signing off. So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 21st and 22nd of July 2021. Starting with very first question, Amrabad Tiger Reserve, which was making news recently, is located in which state or union territory? So this Amrabad Tiger Reserve is located in the state of Telangana. And why it is in news? Because recently the Telangana Forest Department have identified 14 tigers in ATR, that is Amrabad Tiger Reserve, during 2020-21 annual estimation and monitoring exercise. Also, during the previous survey which was conducted in the year 2019-20, 12 tigers were identified there. So in this 14, 5 were male, 7 were female and 2 cannot be classified. Also, there might be more big cats in the reserve that are yet to be identified. And apart from tigers, spotted deer and wild boar are found mostly in the reserve. Now apart from it, few days back we have talked about Valmiki National Park. Why it is important? Because it is the only and only national park of Bihar. And this park was in news because recently authorities there have identified 150 vultures. Then Setkoshia Tiger Reserve was also in news because a particular species of mammal was found there, and it is located in the state of Odisha. Then there is Satpura Tiger Reserve, which is located in Madhya Pradesh, and it was in news because recently it has been included in UNESCO's World Heritage Site. Can you tell me where does the headquarters of UNESCO lies? Please write in the comment section. Also recently,
Two parks from Assam have been declared as national parks, and which are they? First is Raimona Reserve Forest, and the second one is Dihing Patkai. So now, including this, Assam has now total of 7 national parks. So apart from these two, which are the other 5? It's Kaziranga, Manas, Nameri, Orang, and Dibru Saikhowa. So these are the 7 national parks from Assam. Then there is Virache National Park, which was in news. Why? Because here illegal logging was major concern since 2000, but now the situation has been improved, and due to which a species named as giant muntjac has been found here, and this national park lies in Cambodia. Now do remember that recently Rajasthan government has decided to develop a tiger corridor by connecting 3 of its tiger reserves. First is Ranthambore, second is Mukundra Tiger Reserve, and the third is Ramgarh Vishdhari Tiger Reserve. This third one is extremely important. Why? Because now this tiger reserve has become the 4th tiger reserve of the state Rajasthan, and this is also 52nd tiger reserve of India. Now apart from it, we celebrate Global Tiger Day on 29th of July to raise awareness about tiger conservation. Now can you tell me in which year Project Tiger was initiated? Question number 2. Vishwanathan Anand won against which former world champion in the Sparkassen Trophy chess tournament at Dortmund? Actually, in the finals of Sparkassen Trophy chess tournament, 2 world former champions. First is Vishwanathan Anand and the second is Vladimir Kramnik. Both were against each other, during which Vishwanathan Anand defeated Vladimir to win the trophy. And do remember that Vishwanathan Anand is an Indian chess champion who became a grandmaster in the year 1988. Also, he is one of the few in the world to surpass ELO ratings of 2800. Now apart from it, we celebrate World Chess Day on 20th of July, basically to highlight the role of FIDE towards the international cooperation for chess activities and improving harmony across the globe. And do remember that this time it was the 97th anniversary of FIDE. Now apart from it, Abhimanyu Mishra is important. He is an Indo-American and now he is the youngest chess grandmaster at just the age of 12 years, 4 months, and 25 days. Then there is Ho Yufan from China, and she won the FIDEchess.com Women's Speed Chess Championship 2021 title. And she has defeated Indian Grandmaster Harika Dronavalli in this tournament. Apart from it, now Ho Yufan is the youngest female player ever to qualify for the title of Grandmaster, and also she is youngest ever to win the Women's World Chess Championship. Now can you tell me the name of a particular person from the country USA who was Armenian American and also was in news recently? Question number 3. What is the new nomenclature of the Common High Court of Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and Union Territory of Ladakh? Actually, this nomenclature is long as well as cumbersome, so that's why it has been now changed to High Court of Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh. So this order was notified by the Department of Justice in the Law Ministry. And now finally, President Ramnath Kovind has signed the Jammu Kashmir Reorganization Order 2021, and which spelled out the original name. Now talking few things about the Union Territory Ladakh. Recently, NTPC Renewable Energy has signed a pact with Union Territory of Ladakh to set up a green hydrogen mobility project. And once this project would be completed, Leh would be the first city in the country to implement green hydrogen based mobility project. And do remember that NTPC is set to ply 5 hydrogen buses and a solar plant along with a green hydrogen generation unit there at Leh. And already we have seen that recently CESL, that is Convergence Energy Services Limited, which is state owned, has signed a pact with Ladakh administration to make it carbon neutral. And for this purpose, CESL will develop clean solutions for home appliances, electric heaters and various cooking utensils so that they can bear the cold temperature of Ladakh. Apart from this, CESL will also focus on EV ecosystem, which will focus on utilizing the renewable sources of power. Then there is a scheme from Ladakh known as UNTAB scheme, and under this 12,300 tablets is to be distributed there among the students, and it is an initiative of Department of School Education. Also do remember that Ladakh is the first Indian Union Territory to achieve 100% first dose coverage for COVID-19 vaccine. And the Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh is R.K. Mathur. And who is the Lieutenant Governor of Jammu Kashmir? It is Manoj Sinha. Now talking about former Lieutenant Governor of Jammu Kashmir, it was G.C. Murmu. And recently he has been appointed as External Auditor of OPCW, that is Organization of Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, and the headquarters of this organization lies in Hague, Netherlands. Question number 4. July 18 is the birth anniversary of which Nobel Prize winning leader? So this day is celebrated as Nelson Mandela International Day, marking his birth date. And he is known and remembered all over the world for his efforts to promote peace and reconciliation. And also he became the first ever black president of South Africa and was awarded the Nobel Prize for Peace in the year 1993. And he served as president of South Africa from 1994 to 1999. Now can you tell me, Nobel Prize is given in how many categories? Apart from it, in the previous lecture we have talked that India's National Plastic Surgery Day, which is celebrated on 15th of July every year, is celebrated as World Plastic Surgery Day. So earlier this day was celebrated only nationwide, but now it has been recognized at international level. Now one more important personality's birthday is here in this month, because we celebrate World Malala Day on 12th of July every year. Then apart from it, on 17th of July we celebrate World Day for International Justice. Then 11th of July is celebrated as World Population Day. Now can you tell me which state has recently passed a bill to curb its population? And World Youth Skills Day is celebrated on 19th of July. Now you have to tell me at least 3 things which we celebrate on 1st of July. Question number 5. Which country is the Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation host in 2021? So this time New Zealand is the revolving host of APEC Forum, and it is headquartered in Singapore. So recently New Zealand chaired an extraordinary meeting ahead of a formal meeting in November, and US President Joe Biden along with Vladimir Putin and China's Xi Jinping and many other world leaders met virtually, and they discussed on collective actions to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic and its economic impacts. Apart from it, do remember that New Zealand is the 11th signatory to Artemis Accord. What is this? Actually, it is a blueprint of space cooperation and supporting NASA to return humans to moon by 2024. Also, New Zealand is important because it is to launch world's first ever wooden satellite and named it as Visa WoodSat. And this satellite would be in the Earth's orbit by end of 2020. Apart from it, recently New Zealand Olympic Committee has selected the weightlifter Laurel Hubbard to contest in women's 87 kg category. And do remember that she will be the first ever transgender athlete to compete at Olympics. Actually, Laurel does not qualify the important criteria that was needed to compete in the men's category, and that's why now she will be fighting in women's category, okay? Question number 6. Which country supplied the MH-60 Romeo multi-role helicopters to India? So recently the Indian Navy has received 2 MH-60 Romeo helicopters from the USA. And the Indian Navy has formally received the choppers from the US Navy in a ceremony which was held at a naval air station in San Diego. And these helicopters were manufactured by Lockheed Martin Corporation, and they are all weather helicopters which are designed to support diverse missions with modern avionics and sensors. Now, USA was in news due to its child tax credit program. Actually, US government has started providing monthly payouts as part of extended income support program. And now under this program, eligible families will get an initial monthly payment of up to $300 for each child under the age of 6 years and also payment of $250 for each of their older child. Apart from it, US government has recently unveiled an online hub for the victims of ransomware attacks, and this will help the companies and municipalities to find resources and get help if they are targeted by cyber hackers. Also, US Senate has passed a legislation to ban the import of products from China's Xinjiang region because the US has been condemning China for genocide against Uyghurs and other Muslim groups. Apart from it, USA has recently imposed moratorium on death penalty at federal level. And also it has cancelled the JD project, which means Joint Enterprise Defense Infrastructure Project. And now there would be JWCC, means Joint Warfighter Cloud Capability Project. And under this, US administration will divide the contract between multiple companies. Question number 7. As per the United Nations data, which country recorded the greatest increase in children not receiving a first dose of DPT1 vaccine? So, as per the recent data from World Health Organization and UNICEF, India recorded the greatest increase in the world in the number of children who did not receive the first dose of this DPT vaccine in 2020. Can you tell me which of the diseases are signified by DTP? And also the data highlights that 23 million children globally missed the basic vaccines through routine immunization services in 2020 due to disruptions which were caused by COVID-19 pandemic. Now apart from it, recently India hosted the CoWIN Global Conclave and it was inaugurated by our former health minister, Mr. Harshvardhan. Because our new health minister has been appointed now, and who is it? Mansukh Mandavi. Also, India is the largest producer of milk globally with an estimated production of nearly 208 metric tons. Then there is Coal India Limited. It has now formally engaged Accenture as consultant for digitalization of mining process. And in terms of coal production, Chhattisgarh was at the top position. But in terms of coking coal, top producer is Jharkhand. Question number 8. Which institution launched expected loss based ratings for credit rating agencies? So as per the recent framework introduced by SEBI, now credit rating agencies will be required to provide expected loss based ratings for projects and instruments associated with the infrastructure sector. Actually, this rating is divided into a scale of 7 levels, spanning from lowest to highest expected loss. And the instrument rated EL, that is expected loss 1, will be considered to have the lowest expected loss compared to the life of EL7 rated instruments, which will indicate highest expected loss. So this will be a scale for this rating. Apart from it, few days back SEBI had said that India should separate the roles of chairperson and MD in any company. So following this, LIC has recently decided to create the post for MD and CEO instead of having an executive chairman. Because SEBI believes that separation of roles will reduce excessive concentration of authority in single task. Now few days back, SEBI has also amended the norms for independent directors, which includes their appointments, reappointments and removal, and also said that 1 year cooling period will be given for any independent director to become a WTD, that is whole time director, in the same company or its holding subsidiary companies. Question number 9. As per a recent study, cannabis is said to be originated in which country? So as per a new genetic research, the cannabis is said to have originated in the present Northwest China, वेयर द लोकल स्ट्रेन आर मोस्ट लाइक द ओरिजिनल स्ट्रेन ऑफ कैनबिस कल्टिवेटेड मोर देन 12,000 ईयर्स एगो. सो अ पर्टिकुलर स्टडी शोज दैट कैनबिस वॉज पॉसिबली फर्स्ट डोमेस्टिकेटेड इन अर्ली न्योलिथिक टाइम्स इन द रीजन ऑफ चाइना नियर इट्स बॉर्डर विद कजाकिस्तान एंड किर्गिस्तान. एंड द स्टडी ऑल्सो एडेड 82 जेनोम्स टू द 28 दैट वर ऑलरेडी सिक्वेंस्ड. नाउ डू रिमेंबर दैट चाइना इज बिल्डिंग वर्ल्ड्स फर्स्ट एवर कमर्शियल स्मॉल मॉड्यूलर रिएक्टर एंड नेम्ड इट एज लिंगलोंग 1. ऑल्सो रिसेंटली चाइनाज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडस्ट्री एंड आईटी हैज इशूड अ ड्राफ्ट 3-year action plan to develop the country's cyber security sector. And it also estimates that this sector may be worth as $38.6 billion by the end of 2023. Also recently, Chinese port city of Qingdao has a massive algae bloom due to pollution and production of organic matter. Then China has been declared as malaria-free by World Health Organization. And apart from it, two vaccines are important from China, Sinopharm and Sinovac, because these are emergency vaccines for COVID-19 and recently they have been approved by WHO. Coming to last question, Adhi Malai Producer Company and Sneha Kunja Trust, which won the UNDP Equator Prize, are from which state? Actually, these are the two Indian institutions among the 10 awardees of UNDP Equator Prize 2021. Actually, this is a biennial award to recognize community efforts for conservation and sustainable use of biodiversity. So this Adhi Malai Producer Company is a 1700 member cooperative run by indigenous people from the Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve in Tamil Nadu, and Sneha Kunja Trust has protected wetland and coastal ecosystems in the Western Ghats and the Karnataka coast. So your correct answer is option number A. Now talking about Tamil Nadu, SOP, that is Standard Operating Procedure, will be shortly developed by the Forest Department of Tamil Nadu for capture and release of wild elephants. And this will be based on science and its best practices. Then talking about Karnataka, recently it has decided to set up a flower processing center to convert the unsold flowers into its useful products. And it has also launched DBT mobile application recently to transfer funds directly to the beneficiaries. The Bengaluru is important because it has ranked 10th in Indian cities in Global Startup Ecosystem Index 2021. So it was on 10th position at international level, and in terms of states of India, it was first. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide, you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. At the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These are the important news and events from today, and we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Sarthana signing off.
So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 23rd July 2021. Starting with very first question, to which field Project 75i is related to? So this is related to Defense Ministry's ambitious project to design and construct submarines for Indian Navy indigenously. Actually, recently what happened is the Defense Minister has issued a tender amounting 50,000 crore rupees for building 6 conventional submarines under the Project 75i, and the tenders have been issued to Mazagon Dockyards Limited along with Larsen & Toubro. Now few days back we have talked about INS Sarvekshak because recently it has completed the survey data of MV Express Pearl Acid Leak and Fire Accident. Then INS Tabor is important. Why? Because it has participated in the military exercise with Italian Navy recently. Then there is INS Rajput, and it has been decommissioned recently after completing 41 years of its service by the Indian Navy. And do remember that it is the first destroyer of the Rajput class of Indian Navy. Then INS Vikrant is important because it is India's first indigenous aircraft carrier, and it has been received recently and now will be commissioned by mid-2022. Apart from all these things, we celebrate National Maritime Day on 5th of April to support global economy through sea transport. Nowadays, you'd have heard about the Hilsa fish because it has been caught in UP, Bihar and Jharkhand for the very first time in 3 decades. Now, can you tell me, Matsya Setu app, which is for fishermen, has been launched by which institution? Please write your answers in the comment section. Question number 2. Which ministry is associated with the National Logistics Excellence Awards launched recently? So recently the government has launched this type of award and the awards are in the 2 categories. So recently the government has launched the National Logistics Excellence Award and the awards are in 2 categories. The first group includes logistics infrastructure, or you can say service providers. And the second one is for various user industries. So now organizations will be invited to submit entries through the Ministry of Commerce and Industry website. And the shortlisted entrants will present their case to a national jury panel. And the winners will be announced on 31st October 2021. Now apart from it, recently Ministry of Tourism has formulated a draft national strategy and roadmap for development of rural tourism in India, which is an initiative towards Atmanirbhar Bharat. For this purpose, this ministry has also invited feedback from all the state governments and union territory authorities regarding the policy. Actually, this strategy focuses on new ideas like digital technology, development clusters, etc. And it has also identified rural circuit as one of the thematic circuits under Swadesh Darshan scheme. Apart from it, recently Ministry of Education has designed and launched School Innovation Ambassador Training Program. Then there is one more campaign, COVID Tika Sang Surakshit Van Dhan Aur Udyam. This has been launched by Tribal Affairs Ministry and this aim to beat basically the myths, rumors and misinformations regarding COVID vaccine. Then apart from it, recently Ministry of Defense has launched India's first artificial intelligence powered grievance management application. And this is also the first artificial intelligence based system developed to improve grievance redressal in the government. And this tool can also understand the content of complaints and it can also identify the spams automatically. Now, under Prashad scheme, Tourism Facilitation Center has been inaugurated. Now you have to tell me, what does Prashad stands for? Please write in the comment section. Question number 3. Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals, that is DACA, which was making the news recently, is associated with which country? So actually this program is an immigration policy that grants some extra rights to illegal immigrants who were brought into the USA as minors. So this is from USA. And as per the program, they can claim a renewable 2-year period of deferred action from deportation and also can receive work permits. So recently what happened is a federal judge in Texas has ruled that 2012 DACA program, which was created by former President Barack Obama, is illegal because Congress never properly approved it. So due to approval problems, it has been declared there illegal. Okay. Now USA was also in news because of its CRT, that is critical race theory, because it acknowledges that systematic racism is a part of USA. And it was in news due to the killings of George Floyd and Breonna Taylor. These two personalities were killed by policemen there. And for this, a police officer named as Derek Chauvin has been sentenced for 22.5 years of imprisonment. And do remember that this is the longest term of imprisonment ever imposed on any police officer. Now apart from it, recently Indian Navy has received MH-60 Romeo helicopters from the country USA. Then Levon Aronian is important. He is an Armenian American and recently he has won the Gold Money Asian Rapid Online Chess title 2021. Then also US government has recently unveiled an online hub for the victims of ransomware attacks. So this will actually help the companies to find resources and also to get help if they are targeted by cyber hackers. Then apart from it, US government has cancelled the JD project, which is Joint Enterprise Defense Infrastructure Project, and now there would be JWCC, means Joint Warfighter Cloud Capability Project. So under this, US administration will divide the contract between multiple companies now. Now can you tell me the heartbeat bill, which is from USA and was in controversy a few days back, is related to what thing? Question number 4. With $608.99 billion worth of forex reserves, what is India's rank as largest forex reserve holder? So as on 25th of June 2021, India's forex reserves stood at $608.99 billion, and this makes India the 5th largest foreign exchange reserve holder in the world. And which are the other 4? China, Japan, Switzerland and Russia. So India's forex reserve comprises of foreign currency assets, gold, SDR, that is special drawing rights, and RTP, that is reserve tranche position, all in IMF. Can you tell me World Bank and IMF were established by which committee? Talking about World Bank, recently Government of India has signed loan agreement with World Bank to develop GNHCP, that is Green National Highway Corridor project. So this project includes upgradation of about 781 kilometers length of various national highways passing through states of Rajasthan, Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh. So this project is estimated to be completed by December 2025. And who is our Minister of Road Transport and Highways? It is Nitin Gadkari. Now there is a Startup India Showcase, which is in news these days. Why? Because it is the online discovery platform for the most promising startups of the country. So this name is quite important. Last month we have studied that India was at the 4th position in this forex reserve holder list along with Russia. But now India is at 5th position. Question number 5. Indian Institute of Heritage has been proposed to be set up in which city? So the Union Government has decided to set up the Indian Institute of Heritage in Noida as an umbrella body under which all heritage institutes in the country will operate. So this institute will offer master's and PhD courses in history of arts, archaeology, manuscriptology and various others. So it will be a deemed to be university institute formed by integrating the Institute of Archaeology, then National Research Laboratory for Conservation of Cultural Property, then NMICHM, that is National Museum Institute of History of Conservation and Museology, and Academic Wing of Indira Gandhi National Center for the Arts. So these organizations would be integrated to form this deemed to be university. Now apart from it, recently Tripura has initiated steps to promote commercial cultivation of agar by launching Tripura Agar Wood Policy 2021. So this will aim to double the agar wood production by the year 2025. And this agar is actually used in perfume industries. Then apart from it, National Dolphin Research Center is proposed to be constructed in Patna. And this is seen as a huge leap to conserve the endangered gangetic river dolphin species in India. Then National Forensic Science University is located in Ahmedabad, and this was in news because recently Amit Shah has inaugurated the newly built Center of Excellence for Research and Analysis for Narcotics there. Question number 6. Ganymede, which was making news recently, is the moon of which planet? So Ganymede is a satellite of Jupiter and it is the largest and most massive of the moons present in the solar system, and it is also the 9th largest object of the solar system including the sun. So recently the US space agency NASA has released a new video in which its Juno spacecraft was seen flying to Jupiter's moon Ganymede. So this video shows several of the moon's dark and light regions as well as the cratered rose, which is one of the largest and brightest crater scales on Ganymede there. Now apart from it, as per a recent NASA study, nuisance floods will occur frequently in 2030 due to the wobble in the orbit of Moon. Then there is Nia Scout, which is actually a new spacecraft of NASA, and it would be in the orbit by November 2021. Then few days back we have talked about Enceladus. It is the sixth largest moon of the planet Saturn. And recently NASA's carrier spacecraft has detected an unusual high concentration of methane, carbon dioxide and hydrogen there. Then Ganymede was also in news few days back because NASA's Hubble Space Telescope has spotted massive saltwater ocean under the icy crust of Ganymede, okay? Question number 7. Pedro Castillo has been elected as the new president of which country? So he is actually rural teacher turned politician, and he became the winner of Peru's presidential election. So he has been elected as new president of Peru. And do remember that he is said to be the first peasant to become the president of the country. And he defeated right-wing politician Keiko Fujimori, who was backed by traditional allies, by just 44,000 votes. Talking about Peru, it is the world's second largest copper producer and its economy is devastated by the coronavirus pandemic, hence increasing the poverty level to almost 1/3 of the population. Now talking about some more recent appointments. Recently, Haiti President Jovenel Moïse has been assassinated. Then there is Sher Bahadur Deoba, who is now new Prime Minister of Nepal. Then new President of Iran is Ibrahim Raisi. New President of Syria is Bashar al-Assad. And new Prime Minister of Israel is Naftali Bennett. Now few days back, Central African Republic has its new Prime Minister. And who is it? Henry Marie Dondra. Then Antonio Guterres is important because recently he has got the approval by United Nations Security Council for his second term as general. Then our new election commissioner is Anoop Chandra Pandey. Now you have to tell me, who is the first woman to head UNCTAD? Please write in the comment section. Question number 8. Which institution released Inequality Report 2021, India's Unequal Healthcare Story? So recently this has been released by the Oxfam International, and as per the report, the states attempting to reduce existing inequalities between the general category and SC/ST population had lower confirmed cases of COVID-19, such as Telangana, Himachal Pradesh and Rajasthan. And also those states that have had higher GDP expenditure on health, such as Assam, Bihar and Goa, have higher recovery rates of COVID cases. So this is a report by Oxfam International. Now few days back, we have talked about one more report from Oxfam. It is the hunger virus multiplies. So according to this, 11 people die every minute of hunger. Now apart from it, in January month, Oxfam has published one more report titled as the Inequality Virus. And in this report, the Oxfam finds that COVID-19 pandemic has deepened the existing inequalities in India and across the world. And as per it, the richest billionaires in India have increased their wealth by 35%. While the pandemic has stalled the economy, and in turn, it has forced millions of poor people out of job. Then there is one report from UNICEF, which is quite important. Title is Suffering in Silence. Actually, it has been published to highlight the plight of Niger during the COVID-19 pandemic. And as per this report, more than 2.1 million children need humanitarian help in the country. Because apart from flood, disasters and malnutrition, Niger has also been affected by the impacts of COVID-19 pandemic very severely. So in your examinations, this question is quite prominent, that which report is released by which organization. So you have to remember at least the name of the organization which has released that particular report. Question number 9. Which country recently reported its first known human death of the rare monkey B virus? So as we know that a 53-year-old veterinarian in China is the first known human case of an extremely rare viral infection known as monkey B virus. So here correct answer is option number B. And this virus most commonly infects monkeys and it is rarely seen in humans. So there have been just 50 human cases of the virus reported since it was discovered in 1932, according to US CDC, that is Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. So Bunky B virus belongs to a family of viruses called herpes viruses, while monkeypox virus belongs to a family of viruses known as orthopox viruses. So this is a class of monkey B virus and this is a class of monkeypox virus. Okay, so there is a difference. Now apart from it, China has recently rolled out a 600 km per hour high speed maglev train in Qingdao, which is located in Shandong province of East China. And do remember that it is the fastest available ground vehicle right now. Now Qingdao was also in news because recently it has a massive algae bloom due to pollution and production of organic matter. Then apart from it, Chinese giant panda is no longer an endangered species, rather it is now in the vulnerable category. Apart from it, China is building world's first commercial small modular reactor and named it as Linglong 1. Also, Chinese Ministry of Industry and IT has issued a draft 3-year action plan to develop country's cyber security industry. And along with it, it also estimates that the sector may be worth $38.6 billion by the year 2023. Now, can you tell me which countries have been declared malaria-free by the World Health Organization? Please write the name of those countries in the comment section. Coming to last question, who has been appointed as the deputy leader of the house in the Rajya Sabha? So Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi has been appointed as the deputy leader of the house in the Rajya Sabha, and he is also our union minister for minority affairs. So Naqvi takes over from Piyush Goyal, who has been elevated as the leader of the house in the upper house. And Naqvi is also the former minister of state for parliamentary affairs minister, and hence he is also well versed in parliamentary affairs. Apart from it, recently former leader of the house in the Rajya Sabha, Thawar Chand Gehlot, has been named as governor of Karnataka. Then Uttarakhand has its new chief minister, and who is it? Pushkar Singh Dhami. Then our new health minister is Mr. Mansukh Mandaviya, and he has replaced Mr. Harshvardhan. Then apart from it, now Ministry of Textile has gone to Piyush Goyal from Smriti Irani. Now Smriti Irani only possesses Ministry of Women and Child Development. Then there is Dharmendra Pradhan, who was the Minister of Petroleum, but now he has been appointed as the Minister of Education, and he has replaced Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. Then one last name is there, Anurag Thakur. He has been appointed as Sports and Youth Development. So earlier this ministry was under Kiran Rijiju, but now Anurag Thakur is the new in charge for this particular ministry. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today, and we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching, and please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Zaitsana signing off. So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 24th of July 2021. Starting with very first question, FIDE is the International Federation of which sports or game? So this is the World Chess Federation. The headquarter of which lies in Lausanne, Switzerland. So it was founded on 20th of July 1924 and consists of 195 countries. To commemorate the foundation of FIDE, World Chess Day is celebrated on 20th of July every year since 1966. Although its founding was in the year 1924, but we celebrate World Chess Day from 1966. So this day encourages more people to play and enjoy the game of chess. And the most important thing is, chess originated in India, then it moved to Persia, and from there it spread across the southern Europe. Now talking about some more recent current affairs on chess. First of all, D. Gukesh is important because he has recently won the Gelfand Challenge 2021. So he is 15 years old and also the second youngest person to qualify for the title of Grand Masters in the year 2019. Then recently, India's Nihal Sarin has won the Silver Lake Open Chess tournament, which was held in Serbia. And in the same tournament, second place was occupied by Ronak Sadwani and the third by Abhimanyu Puranik. So interesting fact is, all the top three were Indians. Then Abhimanyu Mishra is important because he has become the youngest grandmaster at just the age of 12 years, 4 months and 25 days. Then there is Levon Aronian. He is an Armenian-American and recently he has won the Gold Money Asian Rapid Online Chess title 2021. Can you tell me Levon Aronian has defeated whom in this tournament? Then there is Hu Yifan from China and she has recently won 2021 Women's Speed Chess Championship. Also, in the previous lecture, we have talked that Vishwanathan Anand have defeated Vladimir Kramnik to win Sparkson Trophy Chess Tournament at Dortmund. And do remember that Vishwanathan Anand is one of the few in the world to surpass ELO ratings of 2800. So this was the quick revision of your chess current affairs. Question number 2. Which Indian state or union territory launched the automated auditory brainstem response system, that is AABR, for newborn hearing screening? So recently Punjab government has developed this AABR under Universal Newborn Hearing Screen Program. So do remember that Punjab has become the first state in the country to introduce AABR system to manage the hearing loss in newborn and young children. So this is done under the Universal Newborn Hearing Screening Program. Now apart from it, recently Union Government has decided to set up Indian Institute of Heritage where in Noida, and the institution will offer master courses and PhD courses in various streams regarding this, okay? Then apart from it, Tripura has recently launched Tripura Agar Wood Policy 2021 to promote commercial cultivation of agar. So basically this program aims to double the agar wood production by the year 2025. Then a national dolphin research center is proposed to be constructed in Patna. Why? To conserve the endangered Gangetic River dolphin species in India. Then apart from it, recently Amit Shah has inaugurated the newly built Center of Excellence for Research and Analysis for Narcotics, where at National Forensic Science University, which is located in Ahmedabad. This university is also called as Gujarat Forensic Science University. Fine. Question number 3. What is AMLEX, recently developed by the Indian Institute of Technology, Ropar? So what is this AMLEX? It is an oxygen rationing device. So actually this device will help to supply a required volume of oxygen to the patients while inhaling and trips when the patient is exhaling carbon dioxide. So this process would help to save oxygen which gets unnecessarily wasted. And the device can be operated on both battery as well as line supply. Now apart from it, India has decided to make CoWIN platform an open source for all the other countries in order to enable them to use this technology, okay? Then there is Soberana 2. It is a COVID-19 vaccine conjugate of Cuba. Then IISc Bengaluru was in news because recently it has developed a heat tolerant COVID vaccine. So now it can maintain the temperature of vaccine at 37 degrees Celsius for 1 month. Can you tell me for 90 minutes it can maintain how much temperature? Already I have told you in the previous lectures. Now as we know that Covishield must be kept between 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, while the Pfizer vaccine required special environment at minus 70 degrees Celsius. Now apart from it, few days back IIT Hyderabad has developed Covi Home, which is an artificial intelligence powered COVID-19 test kit for self-testing at home. So as per the team, this kit can provide कोविड टेस्ट रिजल्ट विद इन 30 मिनट्स एट होम फॉर बोथ सिम्टोमैटिक एंड एसिम्टोमैटिक पेशेंट्स. देन फ्यू डेज बैक वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट IIT गुवाहाटी बिकॉज इट हैज़ डेवलप्ड स्मार्ट विंडो मटीरियल विच कैन ऑटोमेटिकली कंट्रोल क्लाइमेट ऑफ बिल्डिंग्स. ऑल्सो IIT गुवाहाटी हैज़ फाउंड द वेज फॉर बेटर वाटर मैनेजमेंट पॉलिसीज इन इंडिया थ्रू वर्चुअल वाटर एनालिसिस. IIT Ropar is also important because few days back it has developed a CPAP machine, that is continuous positive airway pressure machine, and named it as Jeevan Vayu. And a weather forecasting system has been developed by IIT Kharagpur few days back. And apart from all these things, we have already seen that IISc Bengaluru has topped the ARWU rankings in the category of higher education institutes in India. Question number 4, checkmate stealth fighter which was making news recently is associated with which country? So recently Russian aircraft makers unveiled a prototype of the stealth fighter dubbed Checkmate as per the statement from Rostec, which is the state owned military giant and responsible for exporting Russian technology. So the sneak peek of the new 5th generation lightweight single engine fighter jet was unveiled to the Russian President Vladimir Putin, and with a combat radius of 1500 kilometers and 7 tons of combat load, this unique fighter prototype has not been developed before in Russia. Apart from it, recently Russia has conducted successful test of its S-500 air defense missile system. Also, we have seen that Pune-based SII will produce the Russian COVID-19 vaccine Sputnik 5 in India now. Then, India has obtained a commercial offer for delivery of 21 MiG-29 fighters. So actually, the decision to produce these fighters from Russia was made by India's Council for Defense Purchases in the year 2020. And currently Indian Air Force has 3 squadrons of MiG-29 which are operational. Then apart from it, Russia had invited India for the very first time to the Russia-US-China Troika Plus meet on Afghanistan. So this meeting aims to discuss the role of Taliban and the future of the landlocked country, among other issues. So as per the report, Iran has also been invited for the meeting, and Pakistan and representatives from Afghanistan are also expected to take part in the meeting. Apart from it, we already know that Russia has formally exited from the Open Skies Pact. And now you have to tell me which two countries have officially announced to extend TGNFC, means Treaty of Good Neighborliness and Friendly Cooperation. Write the name of both the countries in the comment section. Question number 5. Faster, higher, stronger, together is the updated motto of which of the following events? So this is the updated motto of Olympics 2021. Actually, this was done to reflect the solidarity towards COVID-19 pandemic, and this had been the motto of the Olympics since 1894. Now let's talk about some of the important things regarding Olympics. This time, the flag bearers for the opening ceremony would be Marie Kom and Manpreet Singh. Then flag bearer for closing ceremony would be wrestler Bajrang Punia. Then the flag bearer for Paralympics would be Mariappan Thangavelu. Also, Mary Kom is the new chairperson of AIBA's championship and the veterans committee. Then India's official Olympic theme song titled as Tu Thaan Le has been launched and sung by Mohit Chauhan, or you can say it as Lakshya Tera Samne Hai. Then NZOC, that is New Zealand Olympic Committee, has selected the weightlifter Laurel Hubbards to contest in women's 87 kg category. So do remember that she will be the first ever transgender athlete to compete at Olympics. Then there is Mana Patel. She is the first Indian female swimmer to qualify Tokyo Olympics this time. Then there is Udayan Mane. He is the second Indian golfer to qualify for Tokyo Olympics, Then who is the first one? It's Anirban Lahiri. Then apart from all these things, the 2032 Olympic Games is to be hosted by Brisbane, which lies in Australia. So these are the important things regarding Olympics this time. Talking about BRICS presidency, this time it has come to India now, and for the G20, the presidency has come to Italy. Question number 6, Buddhist remains at Salihundam and fort at Gandikota, which were making news recently, are located in which state or union territory? So actually there are 135 centrally protected monuments or sites in Andhra Pradesh, and the monuments at Nagarjunakonda, Buddhist remains at Salihundam, along with Veerbhadra temple have been identified as Adarsh Smarak in Andhra Pradesh. So that's why it is in news, and the government provides additional facilities at Adarsh Smarak, including Wi-Fi, cafeteria and various other things. Apart from it, fort at Gandikota has been included in government's Adopt a Heritage scheme. Now apart from it, Andhra Pradesh has launched its new Andhra Pradesh IT policy 2021-24 on June 30. So under this, IT, Electronics and Communication Department would be transformed into Revenue Center in a bid to achieve self-sustenance. Hence, it is expected that it will create more than 55,000 jobs in next 3 years. Then there is IBRD, that is International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. It has sanctioned funds of 1,860 crore rupees to implement the SALT program. What is SALT? It is supporting Andhra's learning transformation program. Then apart from it, Andhra Pradesh has decided to set up India's first government-run ambulance network for animals. So this decision was taken in order to further boost the animal husbandry and veterinary sector in the state. And it is also the second state to implement power sector reforms. Question number 7. Which institution has successfully flight tested indigenously developed MPATGM, that is Man Portable Anti-Tank Guided Missile? So recently DRDO has successfully tested this indigenously developed low weight fire and forget MPATGM. Also, DRDO has successfully flight tested the new generation Akash missile, that is Akash NG, which is a surface to air missile from integrated test range off the coast of Odisha. Then apart from it, DRDO has developed a high strength beta titanium alloy recently, and this has been developed indigenously for manufacture of intricate aerospace components like landing gear, slat flak tracks, etc. And the key features of this alloy are good forgeability and high strength to weight ratio, which provides excellent weight reduction feature. Also, DRDO has successfully test fired recently an extended version of Pinaka rocket at ITR, which is developed indigenously in Chandipur off the coast of Odisha. And the 122mm caliber rockets were launched from MBRL, that is multi-barrel rocket launcher. Then apart from it, DRDO has recently tested the new generation nuclear capable ballistic missile named as Agni P. Here P stands for Prime. And this was conducted at APJ Abdul Kalam Island off the coast of Odisha. Also, DRDO has developed recently the CSS, that is Canopy Sovereign System, for indigenous aircrafts in India. It is a type of escaping system for pilots in case of emergency, okay? Question number 8. Which is the first high court in India to begin live streaming of court proceedings? So the Gujarat High Court has become the first high court to begin live streaming of court proceedings. Chief Justice of India N.V. Raman launched the first live broadcast of the court functioning. So the Chief Justice also announced that the Supreme Court will start the live broadcast soon. And this is seen as a step towards ensuring transparency and openness in the Indian judiciary. He also released the Gujarat High Court live streaming of court proceeding rules 2021. Now, few days back, we have talked that Supreme Court is to implement a system for safe digital transmission of its bail orders to jails across India. Then talking about Gujarat, NTPC Limited is to set up India's largest zonal panel at Run of Kutch, Gujarat. Also, Common High Court of Union Territory of Jammu Kashmir and Union Territory of Ladakh has now been renamed as High Court of Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh. Also, Supreme Court has recently issued a notice to Centre on use of Section 66A of IT Act, which was scrapped in the year 2015. So already we have talked about this section in the previous lecture. If you want to know more, please refer to it. Actually, this act provides punishment of maximum 3 years in jail and fine on sending offensive messages through computer or any other communication device such as phones or tablets. Okay. So hence, in result, central government has directed all the states and union territories to withdraw the FIRs registered under this section. Question number 9. Liverpool, which was removed from UNESCO World Heritage Sites, is located in which country? So recently, UNESCO has removed the Liverpool city of United Kingdoms from its World Heritage status. So this decision was taken after the UN committee found some developments which was threatening the value of city's waterfront. So UNESCO had announced that the developments, including the proposed Everton FC stadium, had resulted in serious deterioration of the historic site. And do remember that Liverpool is only the third site to lose its World Heritage status since the list began in 1978. And which are the other two that have lost their UNESCO status? First is Oman's Arabian Oryx Sanctuary in 2007, and the second one is Dresden Alle Valley in Germany in 2009. So now Liverpool would be no more in the list of UNESCO World Heritage Site. Then apart from it, Whitetail Clean Energy Project is set to be established in United Kingdoms. Also, India and United Kingdom have launched a new work stream to promote industrial energy efficiency, and this was launched under IDDI of CEM. What is IDDI? It is Industrial Deep Decarbonization Initiative. Also, few days back, Prime Minister Modi has participated in the outreach sessions of G7 Virtual Summit, which was held in Cornwall in the June month, and it was hosted by United Kingdoms. Coming to last question, Ariel Henry was appointed as the new Prime Minister of which country? So he has been recently appointed as the new Prime Minister of Haiti, because here the former Prime Minister Jovenel Moïse has been assassinated. So Ariel Henry is a neurosurgeon and former cabinet minister, and he will lead the nation until a new president is chosen in an election scheduled in September. Then Peru has its new president, and who is it? Pedro Castillo. Then new Prime Minister of Nepal is Sher Bahadur Deoba. New President of Iran is Ibrahim Raisi. New President of Syria is Bashar al-Assad. New Prime Minister of Israel is Naftali Bennett. And new Prime Minister of Central African Republic is Henry Marie Dondra. So these are some of the important recent appointments. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today. And we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Hatsana signing off.